Hello and welcome to this next video on mobile repairing. We've been trying to look at some of the components that can develop faults in a mobile phone, and we've been trying to understand how we can replace those components in the earlier videos. In this video, we will try and understand one other important component in a mobile phone, which is the speaker or the earpiece in your mobile phone. The speaker or the earpiece is what helps you hear the sound of your caller or the person that you are speaking to on the mobile phone. Many a times, the speaker can develop faults or the earpiece can develop faults due to several reasons. It could probably be disconnected from its position because the phone was dropped somewhere down. Many a times, it could also be some kind of a problem with the cabinet of the mobile phone itself. The external covering of the mobile phone may have dust or some kind of blockages, which could also lead to the speaker or earpiece not being able to play the sound clearly. So whenever you think that there could be a problem with your earpiece or speaker, first of all, try and check the internal systems or settings in the mobile phone. Have you reduced the volume in the mobile phone, or has there been some other changes made in the internal system of the mobile phone? Please ensure you check them before you open up the mobile for repair. Once your volume and other keys are checked and the volume is perfectly all right, volume key is perfectly in the right position, and if you are still not able to hear the voice, check the cover of the mobile. If there are any dirt particles or anything sticking on it, you may want to remove them. Even after that, if you are not able to hear any sound, you will need to open the mobile phone and check the speaker on the PCB. Now, the earpiece or the speaker is usually on the top portion of the mobile phone. In order to check that, first we will have to check the speaker. In order to check the speaker, we take the micro soldering iron and we melt the soldering point which connects the speaker with the mobile phone. Once we melt it out, you can remove the speaker from its position. Once the speaker is taken out, you can now check whether the speaker is in proper condition or not. To check the speaker, we keep the multimeter in the beep or continuity position. We will check whether the probes are working properly, and once the probes are checked, we will try and connect the multimeter probes to the two wires of the speaker to see if there is any beep that comes. Now, if you can see now and if you can hear, there is no beep that's being emitted by the multimeter. This means that the speaker is not functioning properly. The speaker will need to be replaced. You can keep the multimeter probes on any of the points on the speaker, on two different points, and try and test the beep using these two wires. So typically all speakers will have two wires attached to them. You place the multimeter probes on these two points and wait to hear the beep. There is no beep that's emitted by the multimeter, which definitely means that the speaker is faulty. Now, if the speaker is faulty, we will have to replace the entire speaker. Nowadays, most of the work that happens on mobile phones is usually replacement work. You may not be able to repair these minor components. Many a times, the cost of repairing them might be far higher than the cost of replacing those components. So, we will remove the speaker now. We will pick up another speaker of similar description and place that speaker onto the mobile phone. Let's get the new speaker in now. This is a new speaker that we will place now. But first, let's check the speaker using the continuity testing. In this mobile phone, we are using another alternative speaker. This is of a different size and is not of this mobile phone. However, since this is for demonstration purposes, we will show you how you can test the speaker and how you can solder it back onto the mobile PCB. So, let's take the multimeter probes, connect it to the two ends of the speaker and wait for the beep to start. You can hear the beep now, which basically means that this mobile, this speaker is working perfectly fine. So let us now see how we can place this speaker on the mobile phone. So now we will solder it back into the two tips. There will be two tips on the mobile PCB for speaker. Melt a little bit of soldering wire on your soldering iron. Place the wires at the respective tips and ensure that they are properly soldered onto their position. So you can see very clearly, you place it there and you solder it back into its original position. And now you can very clearly see the speaker has been placed in its right position. So whenever you have a speaker problem, you can ensure that you can easily replace the speaker by getting the right kind of speaker for that respective mobile phone. Now there are some important aspects that you must keep in mind while you are trying to rectify the speaker fault in it. First and foremost, ensure that you place the PCB on a PCB stand before you do any work on changing the speaker. Number two, always ensure that you check the continuity in a speaker using the multimeter and ensure that you are placing the multimeter in the right point while you are checking the continuity in a speaker. One other important aspect is when you are taking out the speaker from the PCB, please use the soldering iron to remove it. Don't pull off the speaker from the PCB because that could damage both the speaker as well as the speaker tip on the PCB. Now, the speaker that you place here needs to be of the right size and the right specifications. Please ensure that you pick up the right speaker size from the market when you want to replace the speaker. Placing a very different speaker onto a PCB, a mismatched speaker, can result in a lot of problems, including malfunctioning of the entire mobile phone. So please ensure that you pick up the correct speaker from the market if you are replacing the speaker on any mobile phone. You may want to take your old speaker back into the market just as to show the vendor what type of mobile phone speaker you are looking for. This will avoid all confusions and ensure that you are able to replace the faulty speaker with the speaker of the correct specifications. One last aspect that you must keep in mind while you are doing any of this work is the safety of your hands. Because you are working with soldering iron and your fingers are very close to the places where soldering is being done, please be very, very careful about your hands and your fingers. We do hope in this video you must have learnt about how we can identify if a speaker is faulty or not, or the earpiece is faulty or not, and how we can replace them with a new speaker or earpiece. Continue learning going forward. Thank you very much.